Hello, welcome to the European Open Briefing for Wednesday, March the 14th. I'm Rafi Bajan, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be taking a look at what's happening in the currency markets today. The US dollar has come under fresh pressure, and as we've come to expect, it is related to President Trump and his policies. So yesterday, President Trump unexpectedly fired his Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson, and is also threatening fresh tariffs on Chinese imports. The euro did initially rise on that dollar weakness, but is down significantly this morning following some dovish remarks by ECB President Mario Draghi at a speech in Frankfurt a short moment ago. The Australian dollar, though, is doing not so badly. It did get a bit of a lift from very strong Chinese indicators earlier today. The Canadian dollar is also struggling like the euro. We had some very dovish remarks by Bank of Canada Governor Stephen Poloz yesterday. If we take a quick look at the markets now, we can see the euro is down, sterling not as much. The dollar index is slightly firmer, so the dollar has steadied from those from its losses yesterday. Dollar yen, though, is slightly down still. The Aussie and the Kiwi are both firmer, and gold is also slightly weaker this morning, although it was up yesterday. Moving on to stocks, we can see yesterday on Wall Street, all major indices closed lower, and Asian stock indices followed suit. But we are seeing a positive open in Europe, could be an indication that risk appetite is somewhat improving as we go into European trading. Let's get started then with the dollar. We can see dollar yen did manage to rise to above 107 earlier in the week, but it has since retreated to around 106.50. The dollar index didn't get as strong a rebound as dollar yen. At the moment, it is trading around 89.83, though it has come off its lows. So yesterday, President Trump fired his Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson. He will be replaced by a more hawkish official. He will be replaced by the CIA director Mike Pompeo. Mike Pompeo, like Trump, has tough views on Iran, North Korea, and China, and we may be seeing the first sign of this more stronger stance against those nations, as President Trump yesterday indicated that within weeks he will be announcing new tariffs on Chinese imports, mainly on technology and telecommunications products, totaling $60 billion. And this led to a sharp sell-off in technology stocks on Wall Street yesterday, as well as in China this morning. European technology stocks weren't as affected, as it would be, they would have less implications for European technology firms. But President Trump could see a potential setback from elections yesterday held in Pennsylvania for a seat in the House of Representatives. It is looking very close at the moment between Democrats and the Republicans. If the Democrats win that seat, it could be a sign of what's to come at the midterm elections later on in the year. Also worth mentioning about the US inflation numbers yesterday, which were in line with expectations, showing very little sign of an upsurge in inflation. So that did also weigh on the dollars slightly. Later today, we're going to have the retail sales numbers. So those will be the last major data ahead of next week's FOMC meeting. Let's now turn to the euro. We can see the euro had been recovering, coming close to last week's highs before the ECB meeting. But once again, Mario Draghi has struck the euro lower. He was speaking in Frankfurt today, saying we still need to see further evidence that inflation dynamics are moving in the right direction. And he also commented on the euro, which he didn't really, we didn't really get to see Draghi commenting much on the euro at last week's ECB meeting. This today, though, he seemed to be focusing more on the exchange rate, saying that any further sharp repricing in the euro must be watched closely. So euro has slipped below the 1.24 level, currently trading around 1.2377. Euro yen had also been rising, and it's slightly, only marginally lower against the yen at just below the 132 level. The reason why it's holding not too badly against the yen is because the yen did come under pressure earlier today from the minutes of the Bank of Japan's January meeting. There seemed to be perhaps a slight tweak in the language in the minutes. It said most members shared the recognition that it was appropriate for the BOJ to persistently pursue powerful monetary easing, so that could be maybe a deliberate attempt by the Bank of Japan to tell the markets that there's still a long way to go before the Bank of Japan exits monetary stimulus. Let's turn to the Australian and the New Zealand dollars now. We had very robust data out of China this morning. Industrial output in the country jumped to 7.2% year-on-year in February, beating expectations handily of 6.1%. Retail sales also rose, though they were slightly below expectations, but fixed asset investment in an encouraging sign also rose from the prior months and also came in way above expectations. So we can see the Aussie currently heading back towards the 0.79 level. Yesterday it had reached a three-week high of 0.7897, so it could be potential resistance there just below the 0.79 handle. With also helping the Aussie was consumer sentiment, the Westpac Consumer Sentiment Index, which improved in March. The Kiwi, though, has retreated from its earlier highs. It did manage to match yesterday's three-week high of 0.7354. The decline, though, did come after the weaker than expected current account numbers for the fourth quarter out of New Zealand. It's possible that it did get a helping hand from the Chinese data before that trade numbers started to weigh again on the Kiwi. Now let's take a look at the Canadian dollar, because it's been fairly volatile in recent days. We can see last week it actually had fallen to 8 months lows. That's an 8 months high for USD CAD. It did improve, though, on the once Canada got exemptions from Trump's trade tariffs. But yesterday, Bank of Canada Governor Stephen Poloz drove the loonie lower once again. He said that Canada may be able to have more economic growth and therefore more income per person without generating higher inflation. So this suggests that the Bank of Canada is now taking the view that the neutral rate of interest rates in Canada is much lower than previously anticipated, and also a sign that for future rate hikes will be much slower than what we've seen over the past year, where Bank of Canada raised rates three times. The loonie did head back towards the 1.30 support level or resistance if you're looking at USD CAD, but it has slightly firmed at the start of European trading. And looking at today's economic calendar, we can see there was some impressive data out of Japan as well as China. Eurozone industrial production numbers will be out shortly, but the main focus will be on US producer prices and retail sales, and later on we're going to have those GDP numbers for the fourth quarter out of New Zealand. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching, and have a great day.